Start the recording. Yes, very good afternoon everyone and welcome back to another exciting session of a class for computer. And today we will learn about our ongoing session, and our lesson was browsing the internet. We were learning about browsing the internet. So till date what we have learned, about the requirement of internet, where it is required, then what are the basic requirements now? What are the basic requirements to have an internet connection? So we need internet service provider, you need a modem, okay, and when you have a modem, that time you will be able to connect with the internet. And then what is a www? www is a huge pool of information which is stored online. Then we have learned about a web page, an individual page of information, then website, collection of related web pages, hyperlinks. When it contains highlighted text or images, that are called a hyperlink. When you open the first page of any website or web browser, that is your home page. Then uniform resource locator, that is the address of that particular location. Muslim will shake. Mute your mic or leave class better. Let me remove you from the class.
Sorry, your voice is not coming.
I'm not speaking. Okay, so we were learning about uniform resource locator. So uniform resource locator is address of that particular resource or web address of that particular page. Okay, then we have learned about which language is used to create those web pages. So there is only one language which is used for creating a web page, and it is called hypertext markup language, and its shortcut is HTML, and its full form is hypertext markup language. This language is used to create web pages of our website. Then there are a number of application software called web browsers which are used to access internet. Then we had learned about how Google Chrome looks. So we had learned about URL, the new tab bar, address bar, history button, bookmarks also we have learned. Then we had learned about search engine. So Google is not a browser. Google is a search engine. Google Chrome is a browser, okay? So Google is a search engine. And when we search something on the internet, when you type something in Google browser, Google search engine, so what happens? That search engine sends a program which search information, and that program name is the spider. That program name is the spider. That program, spider program gets activated, and it then sends that spiders all across the world wide web to search about that information. So whenever you type something, so here you can see the search engine sends its spiders out to crawl the web, and they will find out the result, whatever you want. Then they consolidate. Then they consolidate means whatever they have found, they will take it together and give you as your search result. So that is what we have already learned, okay, using our search engine. Now, how to search information? So there are some keywords. There are some keywords that you need to type. Yes, beta? Someone was saying, sir.
Sir, what is this definition of URL?
Uniform resource locator. Uniform resource locator is location of or address of that particular website over internet. That is called uniform resource locator, or its shortcut is, sir? URL. Yes, beta?
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you. Next. Now, we will go to the next point. So here, how to search information? Whenever you are searching information, you need to type some words. So that word should be accurate. If you want to find about the largest peak of a mountain, so you have to type largest peak, it will come. Or if you type only largest, what largest? You need to type that particular keyword or a sentence or a phrase correctly. But before that, let's go to the grammatical part of this. What is mean by a keyword? Keyword means a word. But what is mean by phrase? Who will tell us what is mean by phrase? Khadke, could you please tell me what is the meaning of a phrase?
What is the word, sir?
What is the meaning of a phrase? Phrase.
A phrase can be used in a search engine to obtain the
phrases. I did not ask to that Madhura Harshvardhan, someone is there. Shahnawaz Khan Pathan, I did not ask you. If I am taking someone's name, let he or she answer, beta. So Sarthak, if you don't know, I'll answer, beta. Okay. So we know there are 26 alphabets in English. So when we combine those alphabets, it becomes a group of words. When there is a group of words with a particular meaning, that but it is not a complete sentence. So that is a phrase. Phrase is a group of words, but which is not a complete sentence, and it has a kind of a meaning also. Sentence means a group of words which has a correct meaning also, and grammatically it is arranged. Okay, so that is the difference between phrase and sentence. And whenever you are searching information over your internet or using your browser, you need to type those words or keywords or sentences correctly, then and then only your Google will answer you. Now we have on that day only learned that whenever you search information on the internet, there are two kinds of results will appear. Two types of results will appear. Which results will be there? So first will be your result, that whatever you have searched. Second one be there will be some advertisement also. So few ads will also be shown on your screen. So that is about your search engine. So whenever you search information, you get two kinds of results. One is ads, and second is called knowledge graph. Knowledge graph means what? Where you will have your actual information, and there are, along with that, you will get some advertisements also. So that advertisement is also part of your search engine. But it shows some advertisement also. It shows some ads also. Whenever you search something, it shows some ads also. Yes?
Chapter kaun sa hai?
Who is this great person who is asking, madam?
Krishna Randir Patil.
Okay, beta. So here you can see here. Whenever I am teaching, that time I have added the name of that lesson there. So before asking, you should check what is shown on screen. As we are finishing lesson, that time you are asking which lesson is going on. That's very nice of you. Shahnawaz, please mute your mic. Unnecessarily, you are smiling over there.
Sir, excuse me.
Yes, beta, excused.
Sir, what is meaning of Google Chrome interface?
Google Chrome interface means when you visit Google Chrome. Right now, we have opened this Google Chrome. So whatever you see over there, that is the interface. Right now, Google Chrome is being shown on your screen. You can see that, okay? You can see Google Chrome on your screen. So that is the interface.
Your screen is not visible.
Yes, it is visible.
I have a
doubt. Visible to particular student, he or she may leave the class and join it again, okay? So now I am muting you all, and now we are going to learn here. So whenever you search information about anything, like here, if you just type largest, it will show number of things, largest this, largest that, and all those. But if you search largest planet or the largest,
so I
country,
have a doubt, can I ask?
Largest country, okay. The largest country in the world, so it will automatically give the name of that country. Okay, so by like this, you have to search information in a correct way so that you will get that correct answers over there. Okay, now next one we will be learning about. Someone says someone has a doubt. Yes, beta, who had a doubt?
Sir, what is full form of URL?
From the start of this period, three times I have repeated it, beta. Uniform resource locator. If you don't have a book, buy new books, beta. Or if you don't have books, then concentrate on what teacher is teaching. Akshit Nitin Satpute. Okay, so you have typed a lot of things. Let me check. Why, beta, unnecessarily you are typing over there? Who is that next one? Just let me check the name and then we'll come back to the next point. Yes, I have disabled the mics. I will disable the chat also now. Now you can speak, beta. I have not muted you. Now you can speak. Why you have typed that, beta? Salgar, why you want mic, beta? Your sister smiles or laughs sometime during classes. You want
because
your mic? Yes, beta.
Because yes, firstly beta. I am in doubt.
Yes, ask now, beta, your doubt.
Just now, sir, has asked. You has given answer that, also.
That full form of URL? Okay, so you got your answer, right? URL stands for Uniform Resource Locator. Okay, now, next one, next topic that we had started on that day, whenever you search, you get two kinds of results. One are ads, and one is a knowledge graph. Knowledge graph means information that you have searched about. So here we have searched information about that particular one. We have searched information about Cricket World Cup. So whenever you search information about that particular thing, if that match is going on, if that is currently going on, so that current live score will be shown over there, or its Wikipedia details will be shown over there. Okay, so that is the thing that you can do using your browser. Now, whenever you browse or whenever you search information over internet, you need to follow some rules. What is the first rule? You should keep your personal information top secret. And why you should do that? Because there are a number of people, those we call hackers, which are not good people, okay? They are bad ones. They may steal your personal information and they may create the same account of your name also, and you might don't know also. So whenever someone who is unknown to you, who is not familiar, you should not share your information. Now someone like Salgar will ask me, so what is mean by personal information? So personal information will be like your full name, like your personal photos, your family photos, your current living address, your personal phone number or your family member's phone number, your school name, your personal address or location we are living, or your passwords. If you have any Teachmint account, its password, Facebook account, its password, or any other account you are having on a social network or over internet, Don't share your password with anyone. Why? Because the cyber people, because the cyber creeps, they can use your information and may provide you harm. Or they may create fake accounts of your name. Means you might know, you might don't know. Okay? There are few accounts of your name only. Someone is chatting with someone by your name only. Someone is joining classes by your name only. You have not joined, but someone else is joining. And that will happen if you share your personal details with others, if you share your full name. So whenever you don't know someone, or if someone unknown person is there who is speaking with you and asking you for your personal details, like your full name, your personal address, or your location address, your passwords. If someone is asking, don't ever share that information, okay? Don't ever share that information with anyone, because it may cause a damage or cause some threat to your personal identity. So that is the first rule. Now, whenever you are using internet, this is the first rule of your safety. Today only we had a session on cyber safety, okay, for lower classes 5 to 7 and 8 to 10 also. There we have explained these things only, that whenever you are using internet, when you are browsing internet, you should keep yourself safe, because you represent your family. And if don't know, somehow if your information get leaked, so that may provide some damage to your reputation, okay? So that should not happen. So that is why we should never ever share our personal information with unknown people,
sir,
or stranger. Yes, madam?
Sir, if we share anyone unknown people our password, then it will damage us by using of messages or password.
Yes, beta. They may log into your account and they may change your password. That then you will don't know that password. Now you will not know that password. So you will lose the access of your account. And by your account, suppose they may get your internet banking username and password. So whatever money your parents or you have in your account, that will be withdrawn or transferred to another account. So this is how they may steal your data, they may steal your money, they may steal your information. So that is why we should never ever share our personal details with anyone. Okay. Next is never open or respond unwanted mail. Okay. Because it may contain some viruses, nasty messages, or somebody may be trying to trick you. Yes, beta?
Sir, today we have learned about search types of the result.
Yes, good. Okay, so whenever you have an email account or email ID, and whenever you are using it, and if someone unknown person has sent you a mail, or on your WhatsApp also, if someone unknown has sent you a link, that click on this link and you will get amazing prizes, click on this link, Joy is giving this much data, that much and all that, you should never click on those links or open those mails, because those mails may contain some viruses, some malwares, okay, and it may contain some nasty messages which are not appropriate to look. Beta, someone's mic is on. Why unnecessarily you are turning on your mic, beta? We are not interested to listen your family man speaking, whatever speaking is going on there, beta. We are here to learn few new things. So if you can't listen, don't make us listen what you are speaking. Next one. Whenever you are getting or receiving any new mail, you should never ever open those mails, because it may contain viruses, it may contain some inappropriate photos, inappropriate messages, inappropriate links, which may not proper or may not good for us to look at. So whenever someone unknown person messages you or mails you, you should never open those mails.
Sir, third rule is do not click on unknown call email link.
Yes, do not call or open unknown. Do not open unknown links. Okay, or do not use unknown links. Do not open those or click on those unknown links, because it may contain some viruses or it may trying to take your personal information. Okay. Then
yes.
One is, do not copy material found on the internet as your own work. Right now, many are there. If someone is searching information about something, okay, if someone is trying to search someone, there are already number of videos are there, number of things are there which is present on the internet. So what we do, we just copy something from someone's idea and we show it as ours. But that we should not do, because he or she may claim a copyright against you, or whatever he has or she has uploaded, which may be true or may not be true. So whenever you are copying something, Anushka Sik Prabhupada, whenever you copying something, you should know that you are doing a good thing. You are taking a correct step. You have copied the correct data. So whenever you are copying the data from internet, you should cross check it once, because it may contain some link or it may contain some false information also. So for that, you need to take care of whatever you are searching or whatever you are copying from the internet. Now, next one, whenever you find information, don't trust. So it is mentioned here, don't trust information that you have found on internet. Always we should cross check it. Nowadays, in the era of these WhatsApp, Instagram, Facebook, Instagram, and all social media, it is very easy to trick someone, or it is very easy to share false information or a wrong information with any one of you. So whenever you are getting information, you should cross check that it is true. If it is true, then only you should go for that information. Okay. Next one, if you find information that makes that is not proper, so you should inform your parents, you should inform your teachers, or you should inform your elders which are present around you. Who said beta class is over? Who said? It's 2:26. Still 4 minutes are there, beta. So this is what we have learned in lesson. I hope whatever we have learned, you have understood that one. Okay. So we